Okay, we're ready for the second half. Karen Micah. I'm with the Heritage Commission, previously with the Delaware County Historical Society, the Swedish Cabin, Aston Historical Society, and some other things. So welcome to the second half. We're going to start with site preservation, which is residential rehabilitation, non-residential rehabilitation, adaptive reuse, architectural detail, and restoration. So the first one for residential rehabilitation is for the Kiera House. It's an honors house, and it's the Rhodes Elser, formerly the Rhodes Elser House in Aston Township. And the award will go to Dr. Chris Domes, Dr. Christopher Hogg, Mr. G. McWilliams, Mr. William Leonard, and the Spitzel Architectural Group. The Rhodes Elser Manor has stood on the hill at the corner of Convent and Aston Mills and Conquer Roads since circa 1892, in almost 120 years. The home has had many owners and many uses. A two-family home to the Shads and the Smithams, a bed and breakfast for owners Jim and Caroline Elser, an apartment building, an antique shop, and now the Kiera House. A dorm for honor students at Newman University. An enormous gift to the community, the saving of this building by the educational institution for the Township of Aston is invaluable. This is Delaware County's heritage at its finest, an immigrant family working and saving and taking advantage of American capitalism, sharing their success with family, employees, and community. This historic preservation project fits the philosophy of the Rhodes Odds Fellow as well as the Newman University. Ethical leadership, service in a complex world, stewardship, and transforming spaces. Work included restoring all the beautiful and intricate moldings, fireplace and tile work, grand staircase, wainscoting, and gorgeous multi-world inlaid floors. I think that should be multi-wood. The wraparound porch was restored and original moldings, arched entryways, doors, transom windows, and all exterior lead glass windows were retained. Our next award is for non-residential rehabilitation. Bryn Mawr Avenue Bridges Rehabilitation Project, Radnor Township. PennDOT District 6-0 Trans Systems and Loftus Construction. Three structures along Bryn Mawr Avenue dating to 1905 underwent rehabilitation. The bridge over Meadowbrook Run is on a National Register of Historic Places. All three structures have ornamental parapets with brick stone and cast stone. All three structures had deteriorated significantly and were in poor condition, requiring rehabilitation to extend their service life. The rehabilitation program scope of work included in-kind reconstruction of the decorative brick, stone and cast stone parapets at all three bridges to match existing architectural dimensions. The parapets were reconstructed from reinforced concrete cores tied to monument slabs. All existing bridge date stones, plaques, and medallions were salvaged. conserved and reset. Cleaning and repair of stone and brick masonry was also included. At the Dome Run culvert, the stone masonry head wall was reconstructed around a pipe culvert replacement. At the Meadowbrook Run Bridge, the arch brick facades were reconstructed on both sides of the, and the brick ring stones were rebuilt to match the original construction of the bridge. The scope of the work also included stone masonry abutment repairs, brick arch repairs for the bridge over a tributary to the Meadowbrook Run and the Dome Run, scour repairs, and steel beam cleaning and painting for the bridge over Meadowbrook Run. Adaptive reuse, McKay Avenue School, Upper Trichester Township. Provco Pineville LLC, Fiorelli Family and Lynn Architects. Constructed in 1867, just after the end of the Civil War, the two-story brick schoolhouse has been vacant for over a decade. Sections of the roof were missing and multiple window panes were broken, allowing for significant water intrusion at the interior. The original building had a footprint of 29 by 40 feet with an addition on the north housing a pair of stair towers and first floor toilet rooms having been added at some unknown later date. Prior to this addition, there was an internal stair between floors as substantiated by the frame and stairwell opening that was discovered. Provco Pineville LLC saw the historical value of the building and allowed the building to be repurposed rather than demolished. The Fiorelli family, who operated out of a neighboring building, became the new owners and occupiers of this vintage property. Lynn Architects designed and constructed this project, turning it over to the Fiorelli family in December 2020. This 154-year-old building has now started its new life without losing its original heritage. It's really quite beautiful. Architectural detail, Willows Roof Replacement Project, Radnor. Archer & Buchanan Architecture, Willows Park Preserve, Gillespie Contracting, Inc., Radnor Township. Built in 1910, the Willows Mansion was designed by Philadelphia architect Charles Barton Keene as a wedding present for his bride of a wealthy distillery owner, and was originally called Rose Garland. In the 1970s, Radnor Township purchased the mansion and surrounding 47 and a half acres, renamed it the Willows in honor of the lovely willow trees that surrounded the pond on the property. In 2019, Archer & Buchanan began work with the Willows Park Preserve to complete a multi-phase project aimed at restoring and rehabilitating the Willows Mansion. The first phase of the project involved the replacement of existing black Ludovici Georgian shingle tile roof with a Ludovici barrel tile matching the style and coloring of the original roof of the house, along with additional roof improvements. All efforts were aimed at restoring the roof to the original appearance while also providing an important line of defense against the weather and water infiltration, thus preserving and protecting the mansion and allowing for decades of continued use of this valuable community resource. Work included removing of existing EPDM, restoration of existing chimneys, replacement of existing shed dormer with three new dormers to match historical photos, restoration of existing dormer finishes and replacement windows, addition of three dormers to match historical photos, restoration of existing louver dormer finishes, restoration of decorative eaves and corbels, and replacement of gutters and downspouts. Restoration, Nitre Hall Historic Kitchen Restoration, Haverford Township. Teresa Doherty, Haverford Township Historical Society. Dan Campbell, AIA, Haverford Township Public Works. Nitre Hall was originally home to William Rogers, who owned the gunpowder mill along Cobbs Creek. Nitre Hall was built in 1810. It is a four-story stone structure built on the bedrock of the side facing Cobbs Creek. The mill existed for approximately 30 years, supplying gunpowder for the War of 1812. Nitre Hall is listed on the National Register of Historic Places. The Nitre Hall is the site of the annual Colonial Living Program for fifth graders in Haverford Township School District, as well as Heritage Festival, Oktoberfest, open houses, and the Township Museum. The historic kitchen was altered to form a modern kitchen, which was used by a caretaker and now used by HTHS, but it was not ADA accessible and disrupted the historic flow of the house. Dan Campbell worked with HTHS on the preservation plan, which separated the two kitchens, returned the original cabinets back to facing the historic kitchen, and created an accessible entrance into the kitchen. The original windows were restored and the uneven brick floor was relaid. A brick recess of unknown use was found in the modern kitchen during the restoration, and a window was created to view it from the historic kitchen. The result is a more cohesive and acceptable kitchen to be used for years. Restoration, Lower Swedish Cabin Stair Restoration, Upper Darby Township. Norman T. Glass Restorations, Friends of the Swedish Cabin. The Lower Swedish Log Cabin is the oldest log cabin in the United States. It is on the National Register of Historic Places. The U.S. Government's Historical American Building Survey documented the site in 1939 to 1940, producing a record of 7 measured drawings and 4 photographs. Existing half box winder stairs circa 1790s were damaged and were removed in 2011 to allow installation of a new cement floor. Access to the second floor exhibits, archives, and storage was by a wooden ladder. Using Hab's drawings, photos, and measurements taken during the stairs removal, as well as locally sourced popular Nash stock, the stairs and surrounding enclosure were reconstructed in December 2020. A historically appropriate railing was added. A historically correct handle and turnbuckle were put on the outside of the enclosure's board and batten door. These new stairs and closets surround returned the cabin to the way it looked in the late 1790s after alterations to the original Swedish/Finnish log cabin were made by subsequent English settlers. Visitors and volunteers can now safely access the second floor. Restoration, Spring Valley AME Church, Concord Township. In 1880, the African American community of Concord Township purchased a 1-acre parcel, and they then built a small wooden church along with a social hall and an outhouse. Later, they embellished the small church with a Victorian style foyer addition to the front door. This building served the African American community in Concord for over 100 years when the local population dwindled to only a few who could not keep it up. It was purchased by a local developer who repaired the church after the social hall burned down, but did very little to achieve the original dream of a non-denominational chapel that could serve the entire community. In 2014, Concord Township bought the site and completed it in 2020, the first step in its restoration. The exterior has been carefully preserved in its original state with color selected to match the original paint, and repairs were done to replicate the original fabric. The color of the front door was chosen by a representative of the African American community that the church served. As far as is known, only 4 properties in Concord Township were purchased by free blacks before the Civil War, and only 2 homes built by them remain. This is the only public building for the black community at large that the township has, and maintaining it is a statement to honor their place in our heritage. Restoration, Black Horse Inn Mosaic Tile Restoration, Middletown Township. Sue Muscany, Mary Ann Eves of Middletown Historical Society, Kristen Carty and John Carr, Materials Conservation. In the spring of 2015, Middletown Township Historical Society was alerted to the existence of a lost piece of township history, a custom-made mosaic tile that at one time decorated a hearth at the former Black Horse Inn. The inn once stood at the intersection of today's Baltimore Pike, Route 1, and Middletown Road, PA Route 352 in Middletown Township. The in-building was torn down in 1939 to make way for the construction of the current Cloverleaf Exchange. The tile has been outdoors for over 80 years. It is still in decent condition, but MTHS knew that the conservation restoration would greatly improve the appearance. Plus, it was embedded in a thick piece of concrete, which would make displaying the title very difficult. Over the past 5 years, MTHS gathered proposals for the restoration of the tile and raised the funds needed for the project. In the summer of 2020, the beautifully conserved tile was returned to MTHS Museum along with a custom-built stand for the display. MTHS is awaiting a time for COVID-19 when they can reopen the museum and welcome the public to a new exhibit on the Black Horse Inn that they are creating around the tile.
Move on to publications. I'm Beth McCarrick, and I'm also involved with the Bethel Township Preservation Society and the Brandywine Summit Camp meeting in their history. I'm going to do publication, and it's going to go to Keith Lockhart for the Delaware County History Blog of Delaware County. And I need my glasses for this. Over 11 years ago, the Delaware County Daily Times asked Keith Lockhart to write a history blog for their website. The blog post includes photographs and postcards from Keith's personal collection and news articles from Delaware County newspapers, primarily the Chester Times. The blog is no longer associated with the Delaware County Daily Times, but Keith has continued writing weekly posts, often including upcoming events throughout Delaware County beneath the newspaper article. The blog is available for and free for everyone to view, and in your program you can see the website and go to it. It's very enjoyable. Next award is for special project, the 100th anniversary of the 19th Amendment, Aston Township. Rachel McCullough, Karen Micah, Judge Diane Hulfelder, and Candace Kelso were involved in this. For the 100th anniversary of the ratification of the 19th Amendment in August of 2020, the Traveling Women's History Museum alongside Aston Historical Society and Judge Diane Hulfelder hosted a ceremony at Five Points in Aston and invited residents to view a virtual ceremony honoring the women who fought for the right to vote 100 years ago. The event included a wreath laying and speeches by Rachel McCullough and Judge and Candace Kelso. While attendance was limited because of the time and where it was, you can go to Rachel's website and her Facebook page and you can view the video on there. Our next special project is the preservation of the work of Warden Escherich, Rose Valley Borough. It's the Rose Valley Museum and Borough of Rose Valley. Hedgerow Theater, America's first resident repertory theater, has hit upon hard times. founded in 1923 in Rose Valley. The organization was championed by the legendary furniture maker and sculptor Warden Escherich. Looking for a quick fix, the theater's board decided to sell off its inheritance of Escherich furniture and the staircase. Brian Burley of Rose Valley Museum brought together a group of interested parties to purchase some of the most important Escherich pieces. Their goal was to keep this important heritage in Rose Valley for the benefit of the public. The museum hosted a curated in-person and online auction on October 25th of 2020 for arts and crafts and antiques and fine art from the turn of the 20th century. All proceeds were designated to be used to bid on the Escherich collection of table, staircase, and hammer handle chairs that were auctioned October 29th by Freeman's in Philadelphia. They were able to purchase two chairs in the lobby staircase and are continuing to raise money for the restoration of these items. Next special project is Upper Darby Underground Railroad Tour Guide, Upper Darby Township. And this goes to the Upper Darby Historical Commission, Stephen Nitz and Robert Seeley. This is the first iteration of a guide to Underground Railroad sites in Upper Darby. Due to COVID, the Upper Darby Historical Commission and Bob Seeley made this a self-guided tour by providing a map and a text and image printable PDF that has a page on each of the eight locations. The locations include Riverview House, Cleveland Farm, Thornfield, Riverview Farm, and Fernland Farm, which is Arlington Cemetery, the Museum at Arlington, the Garrett Collection, Hoodland at the Sellers Library, Howard House, which is where Pecos is, Sellers Hall, where St. Alice's Church property is, and Friends Southwestern Burial Ground. It includes a walking tour overview, map, and plans are underway for an interactive tour on an app. And you can view this at the website that's in your program. This last award is for someone who is younger than most of us, and most of us have been in the, you know, preservation for 20 years, and so what she's accomplished in her life is quite amazing. She is Lansdowne Harb. She is also part of the Haverford Historical Society. Her full-time job is to be on the Planning Commission with preservation. She has also helps us as our liaison with County Council and put together this whole event this afternoon. So I really appreciate everything that she does for us. Kate Clifford grew up in Havertown, has been interested in architecture from a young age. She attended Penn State and graduated with a degree in art history and certificates in architecture and architectural history. While there, she helped build houses with Habitat for Humanity, gave tours at local house museums, and helped restore a log house. After her junior year, she spent 10 months in the AmeriCorps, where among other projects, she helped build houses for migrant workers. She studied art history in Italy and gave tours in a French castle. After graduation, she continued pursuing historic preservation and worked for the 18th century restorations. In 2008, she moved to England to pursue a master's in historic building conservation. I worked as a planning and historic building consultant there for 7 years.
She moved back to Delaware County in 2016 and began volunteering with the Haverford Township Historical Society, where she is now on the board as the program and volunteer coordinator and organizer of Oktoberfest, silent auction fundraiser. She volunteers as a tour guide for the Preservation Alliance of Greater Philadelphia and for Historic Rittenhouse in Fairmount Park. She is also on the Lansdowne Harb and a member of the Young Friends of the Preservation Alliance. In 2017, she began working for Delaware County as a preservation planner. In that role, she has become involved with the Delaware County Historical and Preservation Network, the Heritage Commission, and various other groups. She maintains the DCHPN website and sends out the monthly e-blast of events and announcements to groups. She is working on digitalizing all of the county historic resource surveys, and she has mapped the 1936 WPA survey sites created in the 2019 Mill Study and organized all the Heritage Commission events, including virtual programming in 2020. She continues to work with local historical organizations and updating their surveys and having stronger protective ordinances. She was nominated to the State Commission for America's 250th birthday in 2026 and created and is the chair of the local America 250 Delco Committee.
Historic Preservation Planning, the Historic Resource Property Studies Guide, a project for Thornbury Township. This is awarded to Thornbury Historical Commission, Thornbury Historical Society, Thornbury Board of Supervisors, and Mary Sue Boyle and Company. With the Board of Supervisors' permission in 2014, the Historical Commission was tasked with gathering extensive factual, genealogical, and anecdotal histories on three of Thornbury's historic resource properties annually. With over 204 HRPs at hand, their goal is to research each by the time the project is completed, starting with the oldest and most significant properties and continuing with the properties that were standing during the Revolutionary War to present. The in-depth information is heavily researched, documented, and provides an interesting story of our little town and its surrounding environs. To give easy access, these studies are uploaded to the website, and a hard copy of each is available for viewing at the Thornbury Historical Society's Reference Library. All the data, including the historical, anecdotal, and genealogical information, is very detailed. The Historical Commission presents a completed binder at no cost to the HRP owners. The in-depth research in these reports has amazed most of the recipients. The knowledge becomes a welcome addition to the history of these properties and is our township's gift to the individual and families who continually preserve them. And it's a great resource for all historical societies in the county to look at and to try to imitate.
So in the earlier part of this year, our longtime chairman, Rich Paul, died from COVID. And he worked tirelessly for years. He was chairman here for 19 years. And he worked tirelessly to promote Delaware County history. And he worked on behalf of the Heritage Commission. He worked for the Marple Historical Society. He was involved in Broomall. And if anybody here is in with the historical side. You know that, that Rich came to all of our events as much as he could, helped us. He was a phone call away if we needed anything, and he is sorely missed from the Heritage Commission. We'd like to invite his wife to come up to accept the award and the family as well. And this is the Lifetime Achievement Award. And we also want to announce that going forward, we have decided to name the Lifetime Achievement Award the A. Richard Paul Lifetime Achievement Award. As we close the award ceremony today, we just want to make mention that one of our long-term members, Merv Harris, who received the Lifetime Achievement Award a couple years ago, did pass away in the month of April, and he did a lot of things too, similar to Rich Paul. They were together a really long time on the Heritage Commission, and we do miss them. So everyone, enjoy your afternoon, and thank you for coming out today.